After CNN got everything wrong in 2016, they made a bunch of commercials with the tagline, "Facts First," meaning they put facts first, not opinion. Well, it looks like they're gonna have to do more than make commercials to defend that. Now they're gonna have to defend it in court. That's because Nicholas Sandman, aka the Covington Kid, and his parents have filed a defamation lawsuit against the Facts First Network. Sandman was the kid in the MAGA hat who had a confrontation with Nathan Phillips, a Native American with a criminal record and a penchant for stirring things up in front of cameras, and some black Hebrew Israelites who are known to yell mean things at anyone who passes by. Some people saw select video of the confrontation and saw a kid they wanted to punch. Others saw career rabble-rousers harassing a kid. As for me, I just saw yet another disgusting display of the media trying to stir things up for clicks, only showing the angles that backed up their narrative. So irresponsible and crappy just to get people outraged for no reason. And CNN was right in there, bashing the kid as hard as they could, instead of putting facts first, like their stupid commercials say they do. So now the Sandmans are suing. In their lawsuit, they accuse CNN of at least 4 defamatory TV broadcasts and 9 defamatory online articles, which falsely accuse Sandman of displaying a racist mob mentality and instigating a threatening confrontation, among other things. The lawsuit says CNN failed to fact check or remain neutral, and that they took no steps whatsoever to maintain accuracy. Their only goal was to bash on a kid with false accusations only because he wore a MAGA hat. The lawsuit seeks hundreds of millions of dollars in damages to, quote unquote, deter CNN from ever again engaging in false, reckless, malicious, and agenda-driven attacks against children in violation of well-recognized journalist standards and ethics. Regardless of the outcome of the lawsuit, though, I highly doubt anything will deter CNN from spouting anything and everything they can just to get eyeballs, with no regard for facts whatsoever. The media has always been pretty gross, but now it's more disgusting than ever, as it has to compete with social media that never bothers to fact check. It just spits out the story with no responsibility at lightning speed, and it's only getting worse. And this is what the networks have to compete with. CNN will probably end up paying for this mistake, but you can bet they're not gonna learn from it. And that's my spin on it.